So in this, we are going to see the second axis in our lab, background color change using if-else. The same program can be written using the array. Okay, so the first is using if-else class. So first, what you are doing in this program is using the date function. Argument is L. So when you give L, it will give you the full spelling of this week. So it's Sunday, Monday, like that. Actually, here you have to write the first letter to be capital. It's wrongly posted. But anyway, only this is the mistake. The first letter must be in capital. Okay, you try with that. And then print today. Here, what we are doing is, first we are getting the value for this and assigning it to local variable. And then we are printing it on the screen. And then if that value is equal to Sunday, then we assign some hexadecimal, that is color code, to a local variable called BG color. Okay, like that, we get the whether if it is equal to Monday, then we change the code and so on. So based on the day of the week, whether it is Saturday, Sunday, Monday, the color will change. So if you execute the same program in different day, you will get different colors. Then if it is up to Friday, if it is a Saturday, else, we have given it an else. So other than this is nothing but Saturday, it will have this value. Now what we are doing is print. Within print, we have given the HTML tag. So for that, what we have given is BG color. So how you can change the background color in a HTML? By mentioning the keyword BG color equal to. Then we attach this, whatever the local variable, we pass this value to this BG color. So how you can pass? By using slash double quotes dot. So what happens? This is an escape character. So what happens? This will be escape and then it will be added because this is a string. So it will be added. This BG color will be assigned to this. That's what the meaning of this. And then here we print this value. Now we'll see the output of executing this program. I have executed this program of this color. Sunday, that is the one which we are using initially a print statement. Then this changes. When I run the same program tomorrow, it will give me the another color what I have given in the color code. I have for Monday, I have given this. So this color will be printed. Now, the next program, we will see in the background color array. So we store the same values, color codes, all these color codes in an array. Okay. So first we are, as in the previous program, yeah, using the L parameter, we get the name of the week. Okay, whether it is Saturday, Sunday, Monday, that we assign it in today. Then we assign another variable and we create an array. So now BG becomes an array. So all this code, color code is there. As we have already know in PHP, the array value starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you can give the other colors also. So now today 1 equal to, actually I have given only 5, you have to give 6 colors. So you can copy these colors and paste it here. Now, today 1, we are using another, this is just to print the thing in this format. So if it is L, it will print the whole spelling. And then if it is F, again it prints the whole spelling of the month. Then for J, it prints in terms of numerical value for today it is. Then Y is for printing the four digits of year, and then G, I, A. All this is for printing the in the 12 hours format. Okay, G is for 12 hours format, and then A is for PMR, AM like that. And this is what printed. Now we are echoing it. We are getting the value in today one, and we are printing it on the screen. Then we start a HTML where body BG color. For BG color, we pass this variable. So how we can pass that? So print background of today. So today is nothing but here we get the value of today. So when you pass that value, whether it is a Saturday, Sunday, Monday, automatically it assigns it as a 0, 1, 2, 3. So that value will be BG of 0 is this. BG of 1 is that. So it prints the value. So this is how it works. And you will they have the same effect on your screen, or how you have executed the if class, you have the same effect of this, except that here we have stored the color code in the array, and then using it as an calling it as an array, we print, we execute the program.